Welcome to the FoxLearn. Today we will learn how to restore a database backup. First, we will design a simple UI allows you to connect to the SQL Server, then you can select a database backup to restore. You need to include in your project 4 libraries. Leaving the replace database value set to the default of false will not create a new database image, so the database that is set must exist on the SQL server. If you change the incremental value to true, it will create a new image of the database regardless of whether it currently exists or not. Keep in mind that the file path you use here is relative to the SQL server, not your local file system. If you use multithreading to improve the performance of your Windows Forms applications, you must make sure that you make calls to your controls in a thread-safe way. Access to Windows Forms controls is not inherently thread-safe. If you have two or more threads manipulating the state of a control, it is possible to force the control into an inconsistent state. Other thread-related bugs are possible, such as race conditions and deadlocks. It is important to make sure that access to your controls is performed in a thread-safe way. The .NET framework provides methods that are safe to call from any thread for invoking methods that interact with controls owned by other threads. The invoke method allows for the synchronous execution of methods on controls, whereas the begin invoke method initiates asynchronous execution. To use these methods, you must declare a delegate with the same signature as the method you will be invoking. Then you can call the invoke or begin invoke method of any control on the form by supplying the appropriate delegate to the method you want to call. Thank you for watching this video.